we've covered the full range of exotic star-type objects in the universe. Like Pokemon Go, we've collected them all. Okay, fine, I'm still looking for a Tauros, and I'll continue to wander the streets like a zombie staring at his phone. Now, according to my attorney, I fulfilled the requirements for shamelessly jumping on a viral bandwagon by mentioning Pokemon Go and loosely connecting it to whatever completely unrelated topic I was working on. Any further Pokemon Go references would just be a shameless attempt to co-opt traffic to my channel, and I'm better than that. It was pretty convenient though, and it was easy enough to edit out all the references to Quark on Deep Space Nine and replace them with Pokemon Go. Of course, there is a new Star Trek movie out, so maybe I miscalculated. Anyway, now that we got that out of the way, back to rare and exotic stellar objects. They're the white dwarfs, the remnants of stars like our sun, which have passed through the main sequence phase, and now they're cooling down. They're the neutron stars and pulsars formed in a moment when stars, much more massive than our sun, die in a supernova explosion. Their gravity and density is so great that all the protons and electrons from all the atoms are mashed together. A single teaspoon of neutron star weighs 10 million tons. They're the black holes. These form from even more massive supernova explosions, and the gravity and density is so strong they overcome the forces holding atoms themselves together. White dwarfs, neutron stars, and black holes. These were all theorized by physicists and have all been discovered by observational astronomers. We know they're out there, but is that it? Is that all the exotic forms that stars can take? That we know of? Yes. However, there are a few more exotic objects which are still just theoretical. These are quark stars, but what are they? Let's go back to the concept of a neutron star. According to the theories, neutron stars have such intense gravity they crush the protons and electrons together into neutrons. The whole star is made of neutrons, inside and out. If you add more mass to a neutron star, you cross the line where it's too much mass to hold even the neutrons together, and the whole thing collapses into a black hole. A star like our sun has layers: the outer convective zone, then the radiative zone, and then the core at the center where all the fusion takes place. So could a neutron star have layers? What's at the core of a neutron star compared to the surface? So the idea is that a quark star is at an intermediate stage in between neutron stars and black holes. It has too much mass at its core for the neutrons to hold their atomness, but not enough to fully collapse into a black hole. In these objects, the underlying quarks that form the neutrons are further compressed. Up and down quarks are squeezed together into strange quarks. And since it's made up of strange quarks, physicists call this strange matter. Neutron stars are plenty strange, so don't give it any additional emotional weight just because it's called strange matter. If they happen to merge into charm quarks, then it would be called charm matter, and then I'd be making Alyssa Milano references. So, like I said, these are still theoretical, but there's some evidence that they might be out there. Astronomers have discovered a class of supernova that give off about 100 times the energy of a regular supernova explosion. Although they could just be mega supernova, there's an interesting possibility. They might be heavy, unstable neutron stars that exploded a second time, perhaps feeding from a binary companion star. As they hit some limit, they convert from a regular neutron star to one made of strange quarks. But if quark stars are real, they're very small. While a regular neutron star is about 25 kilometers across, a quark star would only be 16 kilometers across, and this is right at the edge of becoming a black hole. If quark stars do exist, they probably don't last long. It's an intermediate step between a neutron star and the final black hole configuration, a last gasp of a star as its event horizon forms. It's intriguing to think there are other exotic objects out there, formed as matter is compressed into tighter and tighter configurations, as the different limits of physics are reached and then crossed. Astronomers will keep searching for quark stars, and I'll let you know if they find them. What other mysteries in astronomy and physics fascinate you? Let me know your suggestions for future episodes. In our next episode, we wonder why Uranus is flipped over on its side. Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it educational and entertaining. If you enjoy videos like this, make sure you subscribe and tell your friends. We depend on viewers like you. And if you want to take your support to the next level, consider joining our Patreon community. These are the people who directly contribute to Universe Today every month. You'll get advanced access to our videos, see secret and behind the scenes material, and get no ads on Universe Today. There are 555 amazing patrons working with us now, funding the work that we do on Universe Today. We'd like to thank Doug, no last name, just Doug, Bruce Hart, and Jeff Burst, and the rest of the members who support us in making great space, astronomy content. Want to get in the action? Go to patreon.com/universetoday. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it educational. Oh, educational.